Hello and welcome to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to share with you my recipe for oatmeal coconut loaf cake. It is gluten-free and dairy-free. I'm using eggs in this recipe, but I'll tell you the alternatives for eggs also. It is a healthier version of your regular coconut loaf cake, but very delicious because of the great flavor from coconut. Let's see how to make it.
Firstly, you'll need 2 cups, that is 300 grams of oats. I have here regular rolled oats. You could use steel cut or instant oats as well. Or if you do not want to use oats, you could replace it with wheat flour or atta or refined flour or maida as well. I've toasted the oats at 400 degree Fahrenheit or 200 degree Celsius for 7 minutes in the toaster oven. Or you could toast it on stovetop at medium high heat for 5 to 7 minutes. This brings out the nutty flavor of the oats and also gives a great texture, but you could totally skip this step. We'll transfer the oats into a blending jar. Into it, we'll also add 1 teaspoon of baking powder and 1/2 teaspoon of salt and blend them until well combined. After blending, this is how it should look. It won't be a smooth powder, but a little coarse, and it actually gives a great texture to the cake. In the second step, we'll prepare the wet ingredients. Into a large mixing bowl, we'll take 2 eggs and beat them really well continuously for 2 minutes until it's light, fluffy and airy. Of course, you could substitute the eggs with flaxseed or condensed milk. The details are on the screen and also in the ingredient list in the description box below the video. Next, we'll add 1/2 cup of coconut oil. If it is too hard or solidified, you may want to soften it a bit, but keep it at room temperature. Instead of coconut oil, you may also use any other cooking oil such as sunflower or canola oils or even softened butter. Next goes in 2/3 cup of sugar. I'm using here regular sugar, but you could substitute it with any other sweetener of your choice. I also like to add a teaspoon of vanilla extract, which is optional, but if you have coconut essence, you may add a few drops of it as well. Next, we'll add 1/2 cup of thick coconut milk or coconut cream, which not only adds to the coconut flavor but also makes the cake very soft and moist. But if you don't have coconut milk on hand, you may use regular milk or any other dairy substitute. Now we'll give all of these ingredients a good mix until well combined. In the third step, we'll add the blended oats into the wet ingredients 1/4 at a time and gently fold it in until you get a smooth, lump-free batter. No need to beat or over-mix the batter. Now it's time to talk about the key ingredient, that is coconut. Here I'm using 1 cup of unsweetened desiccated coconut flakes, but you may use freshly grated coconut as well. And if you have these larger size shredded desiccated coconut, you may have to run it in a blender and then use it. And if you're using sweetened coconut flakes, you may have to adjust the sugar level accordingly, maybe reduce the sugar to 1/2 cup instead of 2/3. We'll add the coconut flakes into the batter and gently fold it uniformly. So this is how the batter should look ideally. Thick but of dropping consistency. If you find it too thick, you may loosen it by adding 1 to 2 tablespoons more of coconut milk or water. At this stage, you may also taste the batter and add more sugar or sweetener if you want. In the final step, we'll prepare the baking tray. I like to use a regular loaf pan, but you can use 8-inch round or square baking tray as well. We'll grease the insides of the pan with some oil and dust it with loose flour to make it non-sticky. Or you could just line it with a baking sheet. We'll now transfer the batter into the pan and tap it on the counter to remove any air bubbles. I like to top it with some oats and shredded coconut to make it look pretty. We'll bake the cake in a preheated oven at 350 degree Fahrenheit or 180 degree Celsius for 50 to 60 minutes if you're using a loaf pan, and 45 to 50 minutes if you're using square or round baking tray. Alright, the cake baked for 55 minutes. It might take a little less or more time depending on the oven. We let it cool for 5 minutes in the pan and then demold it to cool it down completely to room temperature before cutting it. So this is how the cake looks. It's very moist and soft, yet a little crumbly because of the coconut flakes in there. Moreover, it makes your entire house smell great with its warm flavors, perfect for this fall season. It is a nice and simple snack cake. Enjoy it with a hot cup of tea or coffee.
So that was my recipe for oatmeal coconut loaf cake. I'm sure you'll love it if you're a fan of the coconut flavor. If you try it, let me know in the comment section below. If you like the recipe, please give it a thumbs up. And if you're new to my channel, please subscribe and click on the bell icon to receive notifications of my future videos. Until next time, it's bye from me. Thanks for watching.